The alley between the Ryman Auditorium and Tootsie's was the spot that acts hung out in, and when they were trying to get somewhere in Nashville, and the acts would leave the Ryman Auditorium and go over to Tootsie's to have a drink. And in that interim, you would sometimes meet somebody that could possibly get a deal for you. And we did that for 2 years, and till we finally, Chet Atkins would come by, and he'd usually introduce us to someone, and there was always hope, and we were there every Saturday. But we finally got a job. We'd cut Bye Bye Love, but it was just coming out, and we got a job on a tent show, and we toured around Mississippi. And when we came back to Nashville, our Bye Bye Love was in the top 10. And I never will forget the experience, because we went from, when we got back, we got a spot on the Grand Ole Opry, and to walk through the alley and know that you could walk from the alley through the door to the Ryman Auditorium was a major thrill. And as we did the song, we encored three times. Roy asked us to come back and sing it twice more. There's no way to explain that. It was just a thrill upon thrill.
But if it hadn't been for Chet Atkins, I don't think we'd ever made it in Nashville, because our hair was long, and we didn't look like the regular country music artists, and our music wasn't that run of the mill, but down the straight, country path. And so his saying, "These guys are pretty good," made it okay with a lot of people, I think, that for us, we might not have even got a second listen, or even a first listen. We'd also talked about getting the writers that we admired to write a song for this album that we were going to do. So Paul McCartney's name came up, needless to say. And so Dave did tell me it was the hardest phone call he ever made, because he figured that Paul McCartney was always being asked for everything. So, but he did call him up and ask him. Paul said, "Well, yeah, you'd try to write one. If he came up with anything, he'd call back." And I think a couple of months went by, and Dave figured that he'd forgotten it, And he wasn't going to call again, pester him or anything. But all of a sudden, one day the phone rang, and it was Paul saying, "I think I got one for him." And they sent the song to Phil and I. Phil and I both loved it, I like it particularly because it's a happy song. It's about love, and it's so upbeat. It's wonderfully light and airy. It's, of course, it equates loving and flying together, which is wonderful.
When we did the video on Wings of a Nightingale, it was really a lot of fun, because we had to go to a junkyard over in... towards Madison, and we used to live in Madison, Tennessee, and it was just kind of fun to be in the area again. And putting it together, the only thing bad that turned out about Wings of a Nightingale is the portion of the video where they were out way out in the woods and driving down the highway looking so carefree, I got poison ivy, which I had for the whole summer. It was terrible.